what I feel is the biggest challenge humanity is facing is dealing with our stuff, the fears coming up. People are facing stress, and a lot of things are changing. A lot of things are changing beyond what we can see and what we know of. And relating to life in a different way takes courage. And to choose love, to choose to live with an open heart, to choose to live in integrity, to choose to be vulnerable and authentic with people around us, takes courage. And that is the real challenge, I think, right now that we're faced with. So it creates amazing opening, and it can be hard sometimes to do that when we've been conditioned to think differently and when we're reminded by other people not living in this consciousness, you know, the old way. And sometimes we second guess ourselves, or we question if really, you know, we're on the right path. And thanks to shows like this one, and to videos, and to interviews, and to books, and to, you know, people that have the courage, then we're reminded that something else is possible. But I think really this connection with ourselves and giving ourselves that love and connecting really deep within, so that then we can be fully present and fully there and engaged and living our truth and being on our path. I think it's an everyday job. And I think there's nothing more fulfilling than living our truth. And once you decide to live your truth and live from the heart, and once you dedicate yourself to it and remind yourself sometimes daily, a few times, you know, then things shift, your world change, you get the right information that you need to move forward. And sometimes you don't need to see the whole staircase, as Martin Luther King would say. You know, you just take the next step, and the next step, and the next step. It's okay to not see exactly how it's going, but if it feels right, you know, the best way is to check within the heart. As my beautiful friend Baptiste de Pape would say, check there, and if it feels right, move forward. What is your biggest dream besides the coming Juicy Living tour? My big dream really is that there is that more and more people have all this information. You know, I would love to witness and see the shift, you know, and the visions that people like Barbara Max Hubbard have seen and share. That's why the Juicy Tour is taking place. It's you know, it could have any other shape. It's an excuse to share information and to contribute and to do something that I love and enjoy. And I think from the moment that we love and enjoy ourselves, then this is the best contribution that we can do, because then it encourages others to live that truth too. So my biggest dream is really to see that. And also, I must say, to meet my life partner, which I have not. And I feel that this man will play a big role in all of that. That's something that I really want to live and share, and that's also a big dream. That's also a big dream, to share all those beautiful moments and this growth with somebody that understands, and that I can be on the same consciousness, and I feel comfortable and at ease to share some intimate to share some intimacy. And that's another of my dream. Greg wants to know more about your childhood. What kind of child were you? I was a very extremely creative, pencil-driven person. I had to have as many colors and as many paper and pencil as possible. You see what's behind me? It was just like I needed colors. I wanted to see colors. I wanted to experience it. I wanted to let my creativity flow. I would draw. I'm not particularly a good drawer, but I just loved and enjoyed drawing. I also had the chance to have a father that was very much showing me when I was very little flowers and nature and explaining me things that, you know, at that age, I don't know what I've absorbed, but I certainly, having seen his books on Gandhi and on, you know, and spending some time in nature with him and him sharing with me his spirituality, certainly influenced. And I grew up in France, I grew up in the US. My parents were moving quite often, so I'm comfortable in moving, changing, going to different places. I really feel home anywhere I'm at. So that's why I think the tour works well for me, because I feel like a gypsy. You know, I feel like wherever I am, wherever my pillow is, this is home. And I would also produce some little shows. Like when I came back from the US when I was 8 years old, coming from Arizona, back in France, I would do with my best friend, like dancing, you know, and setting up things and having fun and being silly and expressing all that. And we had a lot of fun. But I had always a lot of energy, and my parents have restaurants, so they would work a lot, and I would see them only maybe 30 minutes. So I think I missed a lot of that, like that really that human connection and contact. I wish I had them more present. But what was good in all of that, though, is that it made me very independent and just disciplined and creative, finding ways to entertain, you know, and spend time. And so I think that has developed some cool stuff, and that's why I guess I'm very independent now. But there was always something, you know. I was quite cheeky, as always, and laughing and dancing and a lot of energy, and I still do have that. And I want to, part of where I'm at right now is really, and what I've been trying is recovering, just being that child as much as possible again, and letting that express itself and not take life so seriously, which I can, and just learning to smile and create. And I really look forward to doing more painting and colors and playing all with that. That's something I would say nearly that would be a spiritual practice for me to put in place, maybe for a next 100-day challenge or on the tour, maybe meeting artists. That's one of the things I would love is to be with artists and come in their studio and start painting and exploring all of that. I know Sharon, that is the tour strategist, she has a seminar that she's putting together called The Paint Journey, where you really explore your personal, you grow spiritually just by painting, and she brings you into the moment where apparently you discover some new things through paint. And I can see that it helps to turn off the mental and just to be in the present moment and enjoy. So I want to, that's certainly something I'm very grateful for, You see, this interview too, it's reminding me that this would be great to add. What is your connection to nature? Oh, I'm very moved by nature. I'm so grateful for nature. I didn't have this deep connection that I started to have until I had financial worries and losing my job. I lost my job in London and I had to come back to France. And I was going through a lot. Like, I felt like everything had collapsed and was collapsing. And the only thing that I could think of and be with was nature and just walking. And I really remember in moment of big despair, that was the only thing that I would be called to do. And because it was nearly at some point it becomes panic attacks, and as we know, it's best not to do anything when we're in fear or stress like that. And so I would just walk and walk and ask and try to communicate with nature, because I had interviewed Satish Kumar, which is absolutely an amazing person. And you can check that interview on communicating with nature. And he was just saying, you know, it's a different way of communicating. Just be there, be in the present. You know, the trees, hug them. They have energy. They're in a higher vibration. Be in their aura. They have a soul. You know, all of that, which I had never really... I mean, I've been exposed to it, as I said, through my dad, but really never anybody put it in those terms. And now I go very often like that in nature and walk and breathe in and listen and ask questions and just let the answers and let nature come up with a sign. You know, maybe there'll be a branch or a different path or something that will make you think and feel and see something that you hadn't seen before. And I think this is something I really even want to explore even more. And in that moment of despair, when I was walking and asking for answers, that was a new layer of living from an open heart. I felt all of this energy coming in, and the love and the receiving and giving and the dance and all of life. And I think nature is very, very important right now with the shift, with what's currently happening, and being grateful for it, connecting, breathing in, giving it attention. And kindness and love is super important. So as often as I can, I go and walk in the forest for a few hours. I love touching stones that I would find in nature. Then I connect more to that. And I keep them. I had for a long time my gratitude stone. I would just carry it everywhere. The most important is, I believe, following our heart. And doing as much as we can and as often as we can what we love in every single moment. Being grateful for what we have. Being as present as we can. And seeing life from the eyes of the heart. You know, seeing from this place. Forgiving ourselves. And connecting. And giving and sharing. But really, if we come from a place of loving who we are and loving and being in the present moment, I feel like if everybody would really do what they love and go beyond, oh, I need to pay the bills and this and that, but really just do what they love the most, then this planet would shine and, you know, miracles are possible. But it does, I know it does take courage, and but it's happening right now. I really want to send you a lot of love right now. There is a lot of love pouring from my heart to your heart. I'm very grateful for this new connection. And you're shining and you are powerful beyond measure. And everything is perfect as it is.